Hello everyone, let's have another look at another unofficial Command & Conquer add-on. This time we're going to have a look at Command Missions Volume 2. The last time we looked at Volume 1, which actually turned out to be one of the better, if not the best, unofficial add-on for Command & Conquer, so this time let's look at this one here. I'm sorry for all the reflection here, you can clearly see the camera on the dual case, but I don't have the most elaborate camera setup here. So what you can see is there's this Command & Conquer guy on here with his eye. Looks a little bit like the guy from the Red Alert cover, which is probably what he's supposed to be. Actually, it's a pretty well-designed cover, can't complain about that. So removing the inlay from the CD, you can see it a little bit better and without the reflection. Yeah, this actually looks pretty decent. Once more, we've got that Command & Conquer font, and we do have this typical Command & Conquer face. So this makes a pretty good impression. Again, I think this rainbow pattern on the left there is a little bit weird. It makes it look like someone just took a blank CD and put this inlay in there, but it doesn't really bother me all that much. And this CD contains over 650 levels and add-ons for Command & Conquer. Part 2, Red Alert. Yeah, so once more they call it Part 2. We've seen that a couple of times before. And let's see what's on the back. On this CD you'll find brand new material to prove that your combat prowess and strategies are still superior. More than 650 levels for Command & Conquer, Part 2, Red Alert. Like assistant programs and editors, strategy documents, tips and tricks, and cheats. So yeah, this is pretty much the usual package here, so let's have a look inside. We have the usual install instructions here, not really all that special. And here's the CD in purple. Actually, it looks pretty well done. I'm not really sure why they made it purple. They should have made it red, obviously, because it's Red Alert, not Purple Alert. Is that Purple Alert? So, but overall, it's actually pretty well designed and a little bit better than some of the other CDs we've seen. Even though you can barely see a Red Alert guy on here and just looks like some sort of like circle here that was supposed to be in the center of the CD, but isn't. And under the CD, you will find an ad for Angst, Res Revenge, which makes it sound really awesome, but it's basically just a clone of Doom. Well, maybe not a clone, but it's one of those Doom first-person shooters, of which they released about a million in the 90s. So that's not all that special. I played it briefly. It's not terrible, but at the same time, it's not exactly amazing. Yeah, as usual, I'm skeptical here because 650 levels, those are probably not going to be good single-player missions, but we're going to see. So let's have a look at the actual content of the CD. So let's have a look at the actual maps, and oh boy, there are a lot of maps to look at. So as you can already see, these ones are not named in any well-known fashion. You have a couple of them where they mention the map size. They don't usually don't mention the player size, and once more, this is a complete mess. And a lot of maps advertise this guy's website here. So DG, I think this stands for Digital Systems. I actually checked the website on the Internet Archive, and it used to be an internet provider from Virginia. If they still exist, they don't exist under that website. The website is still there, but it's just blank purple, just like the CD. Ooh. Anyway, so this map here, for example, is called the $1 million map. And the reason for that is that there's ore worth $1 million on it. So what does it add? Nothing whatsoever. So these maps here, 1-1 with gold and 1-1 with gold, are actually identical. So you don't even get 658 maps. You get actually get less because there are a lot of doubles. Now there are 658 maps on the CD as opposed to the 650 advertised, but there are more than 8 double maps, so yeah. And they don't even write out the numbers here. 3 pints, which is under 3 passes, which is funny, I think. There's just a random full stop here. And a German war game. Again, here they actually mention the author, the size and number of players, but that's really the exception. And again, this Bebek guy keeps advertising his own website on the CD, which is not something you should do, really. I think it feels kind of cheap. Here we have Arctic Wolf, not capitalized, 359. I'm not really sure what happened to Arctic Wolf 1 to 358, but they are not on the CD here. Some of them are actually properly named, with the letters being properly capitalized, but most of them are not. Again, these ones here are the same. This one is just called final. What that's supposed to be, I don't know. And again, actually this is not only a double map, this is a triple map. And occasionally you have maps that are named the same, but are not the same map. And occasionally you also have maps that are not the same, but that actually don't have the same name, but they're still the same map. So it's not even consistently scamming you, no. This one here is an Arctic map, which is awesome. No other map tells us that, except when it has a name like Winter. These maps are called Complete, I think Ganz und Complete in German. So it's a complete mess. It's a complete mess. And we're going to check out a couple of these maps. Nevertheless, also Nazi Return, yeah, that's classy. So here is the Nazi Return map. I just had to start with that one. And as you can see, it's a map that at least built consistently in the sense that there are no graphical artifacts. And it's basically an island with resources and beaches. There are no Nazis on the map, I can see. And that's one of the problems. With, oh yeah, ooh, look, there's a couple of rocks in this otherwise completely green area. Amazing. Look at the attention to detail. And that's one of the problems with these maps, that they aren't named in any way that makes a whole lot of sense. So the original Red Alert maps, or the ones from the expansion that is the official ones, they have names that actually make sense. For example, there's one called Come to the Navy, or Join the Navy, and there's another one called The Battle of Trafalgar, named after the famous Battle of Trafalgar. Actually, I think it's called Return to Trafalgar, but that doesn't really matter. They probably going to overwhelm me here because I didn't build stuff fast enough. Point is that these maps actually have names that tell you something about the map, and these ones here do not. So, are you going to engineer rush me? So, well, it doesn't really matter. So that's the whole thing here. So these maps here just have random names or names that make no sense whatsoever, and as a result you do not only get any information on the map if you check them out in the menu, because they're just named nonsensical strings of letters or just advertised the author's website. And not only don't get information there, but you also don't get any information from the title, which is another thing that's pretty bad. So do you really want to go to 650 maps just to find out which ones are good and which ones are not? Probably not, to be honest. On this map, you start in another one of those positions where you can't deploy your MCV, which already indicates pretty poor map design. But at least you do have a bunch of resources here. I'm not really sure why they like to do that. That just happens over and over again. They start you in a position like this, and that's pretty much not where you should position MCV, because it just wastes everybody's time. It's good to give people options where to deploy the MCV, but there's no real need to simply put them in a position where they can't deploy it straight away. I'm not really sure how the AI deals with that. Occasionally it doesn't really seem to be all that good at dealing with it, which is another minus. So again, this map here is, it actually looks pretty decent compared to a couple of the other maps. You do have a decent amount of resources here. Again, tree placement is a little bit lazy, and this map is called United Kingdom World War II Under Siege. United Kingdom written with a hyphen, because why not? And on this map here you actually have a very limited space to do your stuff. It really depends on how many players are on this map, so I'm only accompanied by one other AI player, but if there are several players you only have so much space you can use to expand before you actually harvest all of that. So, and that does give you some interesting options, because you have this bottleneck here, and it does mean you have to think carefully what you build first, because you can only squeeze so much stuff on here. And this map is also pretty well designed in the sense that there are no artifacts and it's consistent, the roads end properly and stuff like that. So yeah, this is actually a map that has something going for it. So it looks good, and it does have some interesting tactical things going for it. And I'm already running out of space, so oops, should have built another power plant. Yeah, this is actually a map that isn't all that bad, but it took me about another 10 maps to find one map that's halfway decent, and that's not a good sign, not at all. So this is the $1 million map, and as you can see, there's a little bit of resources here. There are those trees and some other obstacles, and that's pretty much it. This map is largely empty. So yeah, these maps aren't even bad in the sense that the beach lines don't line up and stuff like that. They are just lazy. They're just really, really lazy, and it seems there's some sort of maximum amount of effort you can put into these maps, and then once you've used that up, you have to distribute it over all the maps. So the more maps you make, the lower the quality of all the maps is, which probably makes sense because, I mean, we all have only limited time, and that has to go somewhere. And really, that's, and the thing with the resources, there aren't even larger amounts of resources. No, they're all scattered over the map in really small patches, which is a weird choice, but doesn't really add anything. It just means your harvesters have to use some more time to actually get stuff done. Overall, this map has very little going for it. Now, this map here is called Juice House 2. I'm not really sure why. It doesn't really seem to have a lot to do with Jews. It doesn't really seem to be anti-Semitic anyway, or pro-Jew or whatever. As you can see, look at this ore field. Isn't it nice and rectangular and really lazily placed? Yes, it is. And look at these trees. It's not only trees all over again, it's the very same asset recycled over and over and over again. Same goes for these plane wrecks here, and this map is also really unbalanced. Yeah, same goes for the beach. Because I started on a nice patch here, but different players start on different patches, and some of them are far away from resources, and others have to start on area where they again can't deploy their MCV right away, so they have to drive, and it gives them a disadvantage for no real reason. Oh, look at that, more of the same trees. There's no real reason why you would ever do that, and it just handicaps certain players. And there's really no reason why you should do that, unless you explicitly want to design a map where some players are disadvantaged and others are not. And hey, look at this. Doesn't this look splendid? All these... Oh, look at that, a crate. Yeah, again, this is a pretty lazily designed map. And again, I wish they would actually put... Ooh, look at that. Got a nice infantry team here, including engineer. And I wish they would just make less maps and would make those maps better, because you would actually profit from that. Yeah, and also have this nice bottleneck here. My neighbor does so too, but other players do not. So overall, very imbalanced map. If you do that, then give some indication that it is unbalanced, because this map is huge, is very, very unbalanced. So more unbalanced than it should be if this is intended to be a normal multiplayer map. Now this map here is called Pyramid Wars, and you can probably see why it's called Pyramid Wars. And this map actually has something going for it, in the sense that you have this pyramid design here. You start here, so it's really awkward to start up your base, because there doesn't really seem to be any good position to do it. And the AI is not very good at dealing with this map, because you have to think carefully where you place your buildings. For example, I can't go through here, I messed that up. But yeah, kind of everything. But again, look at this, they're just reusing the same stuff here over and over and over again, and again, it's lazy. And, oh, look at that, so there's blue team. And this map is actually one of the better maps, because I generally like this concept here, but then again, you shouldn't really be that lazy with all these assets here, and I should have more power. And there's also the fact that most of the maps aren't even like this, so whoop, that's not good, so can you please attack those guys? Yeah, should have done this differently. So can I build a flame tower down there? Hopefully I can. So yeah, what I want to say is most of the maps aren't like this, so this is even the exception, even though the map design is still mostly lazy. So yeah, not much to say here apart from that. I generally like the map design, but it still should have been done better. And I think this is the last map I'm going to show you, because there isn't really all that much to show otherwise. I did play about, I think, 50 or 60 maps here, and all of them are pretty much the same. Almost all of them are lazily slapped together multiplayer maps. There are no single player maps whatsoever on this map. And ooh, there's green team. And overall, this add-on has very little going for it. It is actually better than Level Alert, because Level Alert had more artifacts and stuff like that, but at the same time, it has less maps that actually have something going for them. So overall, this one here does not get a recommendation from me, because there's really no reason to give it one. And I'm really disappointed, because I had hoped that Command Missions 2 would be like Command Missions Volume 1, where you actually had some, yeah, sure, built a power plant there. Yeah, you need to plan this map carefully, which is actually good. The Command Mission 1, where you actually had those individual missions, which actually weren't just slapped together multiplayer missions. Those missions actually had something going for them. A lot of them were quite creative. Not always executed well, but still solid in with their ideas. But now they got lazy, and this map doesn't have anything going for them anymore. So yeah, that's pretty much it for Command Missions Volume 2. Yeah, I hope next week's add-on is going to be a little bit more interesting. But yeah, we'll see. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care and goodbye.